Hey, yo, man. Man, what's taking on me so long, son?
Calm down. Calm down.
Hey, man. Wish death upon me. Blood in my eye, dog, and I can't see. I'm trying to be what I'm destined to be. And niggas trying to take my life away. I put a hole in a nigga for fucking with me. My back on the wall, now you gon' see. Better watch how you talk when you talk about me. Cause I'll come and take your life away. Many men, many, 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 many men. Wish death on me, Lord. I don't cry no more. Don't look to the sky no more. Have mercy on me. Pussy niggas put money on my head, dog. Get your refund, motherfucker. I ain't dead. I'm the diamond in the dirt that ain't been found. I'm the underground king, and I ain't been crowned. When I bound, something special happen every time. I'm the greatest. Something like Ali in this prime. I walk the block with the bundles. I've been knocking the humble. Swing the ox when I rumble. Show your ass with my gun. Got a temper, nigga. Go ahead. Lose your head. Turn your back on me. Get clapped and lose your legs. I walk around, gun on my waist. Chip on my shoulder, top bust a clip in your face. Post to this beat, ain't no. Many men. Many, 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 many men. Wish death upon me, Lord. I don't cry no more. Don't look to the sky no more. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on my soul. Don't let my heart turn cold. Have mercy on many men. Many, 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 many men. Wish death so that it wouldn't be special if it wasn't for rain. Joy wouldn't feel so good if it wasn't for pain. Death gotta be easy, cause life is hard. It'll leave you physically, mentally, and emotionally scarred. This is for my niggas on the block, with some treating cigars. For the niggas on lock, doing life behind bars. I don't see only God can judge me, cause I see things clear. Quick dispatches to give my black ass 100 years. I'm like Paulie and Goodfellas, you can call me the Don. Like Malcolm by any means, with my gun in my palm. Slim switch sides on me, let niggas ride on me. I thought he was cool, why you want me to die? Call me many men. Many, 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 many men. Wish death upon me, Lord. I don't cry no more. Don't look to the sky no more. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on my soul. Don't let my heart turn cold. Have mercy on many men. Many, 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 many men. Every night I talk to God, but he don't say nothing back. I know he protected me, but I still stay with my gat and my nightmares. Niggas keep putting checks on me. Type say some bitch done put a hex on me. The feds didn't know much when Pop got shot. I got a kite from the pins that told me Tuck got knocked. I ain't gonna spell it out for you motherfuckers all the time. Are you a literate nigga? You can't read between the lines. In the Bible it says, what goes around comes around. I'ma shot me. 3 weeks later, he got shot down. Now it's clear that I'm here for a real reason. Cause he got hit like I got hit, but he ain't fucking breathing. Many men. Many, 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 many men. Wish death upon me, Lord. I don't cry no more. Don't look to the sky no more. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on my soul. Don't let my heart turn cold. Have mercy on many men. Many, 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 many men. Wish death upon me.
Find the best there is, plain and simple. I mean, I wake up in the morning, I piss excellent. Find the best there is, plain and simple. I mean, I wake up in the morning, I piss excellent. Find the best there is, plain and simple. I mean, I wake up in the morning, I piss excellent.
Shit. You done fucked up, man.
You done put two of them at one in the same motherfucking place at the same motherfucking time. Y'all niggas about to feel this. Break out the champagne glasses, motherfucking condoms. One on us. I paint a perfect picture, bomber who just with precision. My intentions took you with you with that double OP. Dog, my fucking homie, use a cold ass to go on them all.
Showing up, I keep my hand on the gun, cause they got me on the run. Now we're back in the courtroom, waiting on the outcome. Free Tupac is all this on the niggas' mind, but at the same time, it seems they trying to take mine. So I'm gonna get smart and get defensive of this shit, and put together a million march for some gangster shit.
So now they got a slate, two multi-millionaire motherfuckers catch the case. Bitches get ready for the throwdown, the shit's about to go down. Me and Snoop about to clap. I'm losing my religion. I'm vicious on these stool pigeons. You might be deep in this game, but you got the rules missing. Niggas be acting like you're savage. Say I'm gonna get the cabbage. I got nothing but love.
I'm the best there is, plain and simple. I mean, I wake up in the morning, I piss excellent.
Damn. Road tie, daddy. Road tie. Football's back. At least for the week. Oh, it was so glorious to see some football. Yeah, I even watched the damn Ohio State A-Day game while I was at work. I was like, fuck it, it's football. Let's watch it. Fucking traitor. Went to Ohio State. We lost Caleb Downs to Ohio State. I hope he breaks his leg. No, I'm just kidding. No, I'm serious. I hope he does. I know it's wrong, but everybody's raving about the offense. 31 points against our number one defense. I'm like, well, I don't know if I'm raving about that offense. Yeah, Jesus Christ. We're going to have to score 35 points and 50 points to win a game with this defense. Which was my fear that we would become an offensive juggernaut and forget about defense. And you can't do that in the SEC, baby. You got to play defense. So, yeah, we'll see. It's hard to take a spring game serious, too serious. I mean, you want to see improvement. You want to see what you have. But in reality, you don't want it to be like lopsided, like 31 to fucking 7. That's not a good spring game. To me, it's not. It means the defense is way behind. And it's usually the opposite. But I'll take it. It is what it is. It's football. And we'll see how we do. It was really weird not seeing Coach Saban out there. He was at the game. Still going to take a little while to get used to that. That's for sure. Welcome in. I hope everybody's having a beautiful Saturday. This will not be a long stream. It'll be a little one. Just the one to go over this beautiful Paco Rabanne box pack I bought. Look at this. Look at this fucking box they sent me for one fragrance. I mean, come on. Do I feel special? I sure do. I'm excited about that. I came in today. I was supposed to come in yesterday, but I didn't for some reason. So I give up. But yeah, it ain't nothing but a gangster party. The party to be at for at least the next 30, 40 minutes is going to be here. I want to say thank you for all the love and support you show this channel. It is growing exponentially and more than I can even tell you. How fast this channel is growing. It is nuts. We are going to be at 7,500 by probably July at this pace. This is nuts. And this is real. Now, before it was fun. It still is fun, but now it's like, damn, I got to put out content. I got to do a little bit more now. I got to do this. I can do that. Damn. It's hard to keep up with all the comments now. It's going to get harder. So, and plus the sale this weekend is just blowing up. I don't even want to look how many orders I got to work on tonight. And the pre-orders from the Duas. Oh, my God. This is my favorite Eminem song, by the way. This is real Eminem. This is real Eminem. You can have the rest of that shit, that new song. Take it all. Give me this song. It's all I need from Eminem, and I'm good. This is the best Eminem song of all time, without doubt.
Dallas, fuck out of here.
You see, just Marshall Mathers, Mathers.
Just a regular guy.
I don't know why all the fuss about me.
It's about me.
Nobody ever gave a fuck before. All they did was doubt me.
It was doubt me.
Now everybody with a money mouth and wanna take shots at me.
Take shots at me.
Walking. You might see me walking a dead rock while a dog with his head chopped off in the park with a spike collar.
Some bitch will quit barking. Dang it. That's real Eminem. You can have this grown-up Eminem's fucking stupid song. Oh, my God. If I'm Benzino, ooh, you said I have a neck like a giraffe. Ooh, I'm so hurt. You know what? That's not a dish, okay? That's why I fucked your bitch, you fat motherfucker. That's a dish, okay? It's just, and I don't know. Eminem's just boring. 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 It's the same old boring Eminem. It's boring. Nobody touches this shit right here, man. I'm sorry.
Thinks the killing thing. Don't get me started. These fucking brats can't sing and Britney's garbage. What's this bitch retarded? Give me back my $16. All I see is sissies and magazines smiling. Whatever happened to wilding out and being violent? Whatever happened to catching the good old backs and passing it ass? We're gonna get in your shoes, come your ass to be. New kids on the block, suck a lot of dick. Boy, girl, who's sick, me sick. And I can't wait
till I cast all you faggots in public. I'ma love it. Oh my God. Then he wouldn't have dyed hair just like me. That's a dish. Anyways. Welcome in. Let's say hi to the chat. Get this party started. Orange, what's going on? World War II. What did I miss, man? Some kind of fucking news I miss? You say that every time, Orange, you come on here, by the way. I think I have 37 orders. No, 28 orders to fill. 30. No, fuck, it ain't updated. 33 orders to fill. Son of a bitch. If you want a sample, do us celebration week. My scent of the night is Tigers Madagascar Vanillic Rum, one of the best tiger blends there is. I love this fragrance. It smells like Bigard's Tiger. It smells like that beautiful Madagascar Vanillic oil they use at Dua. Phenomenal. So I ordered a couple more things. I think I ordered the New Zahar off. I don't know if it's for ladies or guys, but I ordered two bottles, and you can pre-order it now if you want to. There's a special pre-order code, since there's no promos that will work with that. Use promo code BLOOM5 to get 5% off your Zahar off order. Is it a ladies' fragrance? I don't know. I just bought it because I buy them all anyways. My wife sent me the picture. I said, oh, shit, he does have something coming out. That's how much I'm in the know, by the way. Might be nice. Anyways, what's up, Scott the Rinse Martin, baby's on fire. Yeah. Make sure you hit the like button. Let's put that banner up. There we go. I was feeling a little fired up with the other banner. great to see Scott here. Great to see Kevin Hawthorne all the way from Lakeland, Florida. General Giggles is here. DWJ's here. Smelly Man's here. What's up, baby? The Man. 1984. San Jose Oud Wood. Great fragrance, man. Great fragrance. San Jose Vanilla Outlaw. Smelly Man showing off right now with that discontinued gem. The fat mob, baby. Yeah. Saturday PDM Parfums de Marley Shaggy. I don't fucking know. I give up. Best part.
And buy this cheap ass little magazine with a food stamp.
I'm gonna go back a little bit.
Right, what do I see? A picture of my
let me back up a little bit.
Okay, my favorite part is this part. Aggravated. I won't ejaculate in this blonde mop that's on top. This fucked up head that I've got. I've gone pop. The underground just spunned around. See the 360. Now these kids diss me and act like the big sissies. Oh, he just did some shit to Smithy. So now he thinks he's too big to do some shit for them to get busy. My fucking bitch mom suing for 10 million. She must want a dollar for every pill I've been stealing. Shit, where the fuck you think I picked up the habit? All I had to do was go in the room and lift up a mattress. Which is a bitch, Mr. Briggs and Miss Mathers.
Damn. That shit's so fire. It gives me chill bumps. Literally chill bumps on my arm. How great that rap song is. And he would love to distance himself from it. Prick. People get rich. They forget about shit. All that was Hungry Eminem. I miss Hungry Eminem. Now I get this bullshit. You almost 50, brother. You can stop trying to be cool. Just make music like this and they'll all come back. I promise you. Eminem says, or Marshall Mathers, he says, Marshall Mathers is back, and I'm doing a whole Marshall Mathers album. That son of a bitch will be the most awaited album. You think Beyonce's big? That wouldn't even make a dent. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying, but that ain't his flow no more. I'm Eminem. Fucking bad. What is up, Ismael? Great to see you rocking at La Tafas Houdin, great to see you there, Ismael. LaShawn's here. Got some new duos in today. I saw your video. Milkylicious, baby. Milkylicious. The Milk Patrol is out. Yeah, baby. I have Milkylicious. I don't think it smells that good, but that's me. And my wife likes sugary fancy cotton candy, though. She's like, do you have sugary fancy cotton candy? I said, well, yes, I do. Here it is. You can wear it. Ombre Nimbus is the best. Ombre Nimbus, California vibe, and if you can find it anymore at a decent price, the other one, the afternoon swim clones, I'm drawing a damn blank now. Those from Luciano are the best out there, and it's not even close. Great to see you, John. Fastest shipping again. Yeah, your order went out yesterday, baby. Montrese didn't have. What's up, Montrese? Yeah, that sweet stogie is a nice fragrance, man. I had a bunch of it, so I did a, you know, I try to mix it up, but I'm lazy, so I grabbed the first thing I see, which was sweet stogie, like several times in a row. Like, I have samples I'm going to make of this one. Everybody's tried this if you haven't. Legend. What's this called? It's the damn Azaro Legend, I think. Chrome Legend. Like, I'm doing a sample of that one. I'm doing some Penguins Premium Blend. Cheap stuff, you know. I can't really do all the expensive stuff. Then I got some Azaro Chrome. I got some Banana Republic, some ladies' fragrances, but I already made up a bunch of samples, but I'm going to need to make more. But yeah. Fluffy marshmallows. Yeah, that one was a hit for a while. Dirty Banana is good. Dirty Banana is worth the money. My wife doesn't like it, but I do. She don't like a dirty banana. We're going to tell you. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Rubber dub dub. I don't even know what that is. What is genre open window next Friday? What is that, LaShawn? I have no idea what that is. Are you talking about the new fragrance from Genre Parfums? I had no idea what it was. What is the best? James asked, what is the best summer duo that gets compliments? Anything with Rendezvous. So Caribbean Rendezvous. Anything with Baccarusa 40. So let's say Supernova in a Casino. Anything with Rendezvous, but Blue Caribbean Duo, fantastic. But if you just want like an original duo that gets compliments for the summer, I would say Workout Elixir. I would say Mediterranean Sea. I would say it's a blend, though, and that is Casino Royale Therapy Nights. That thing will get you the most compliments of anything. It's a stunner. A stunner. One of the best deal of the ever made by Duo. Well, LaShawn, I bought two when in Puerto Rico's. They should be here soon. That would be the only one I would be buying from Genre that I saw I liked. And I sell a lot of when in Puerto Rico. Matter of fact, where the fuck is that package? I've been waiting for a while. When I know I ordered it like last week. I'm still waiting. That's weird. All right, let's do this. So I went to Paco Rabanne's website and they sent me this beautiful box now. This beautiful box for one fragrance. There's some free gifts in here that I'm going to give my wife, but I didn't want to open it until I got you guys here. Now, the free gifts were a part of me purchasing the fragrance at retail price, and I got I signed up and got 10% off, or I think what it was, 15% off. Nowhere, it might be available somewhere now, but it was not available at the time of my purchase. And you know me, I can't wait around. I need it in my store. I need to review it. I need to wear it. I'm a huge Invictus guy. I have all the Invictus that matter. Aqua, Intense, Platinum, I sold. Victory and Elixir, I think I still have. And the regular Invictus. So they sent me all this stuff in here. There's a good look at the Paco Rabanne. What do we got in here? What do we got in here? There's a letter. It says, Dear Fat Boy, we appreciate all you do. You are the realest reviewer ever. I'm just joking. Don't say that. There's nothing in here. Fucking card, I think. What is this? It says, Paco Rabanne thanks you for your order. Prepare with care to be worn with boldness. See you very soon. What is this? A golden ticket? So I have a golden ticket. I guess I'm going to Paco Rabanne. Look at shit. This is my receipt where I paid for it. Blah, blah, blah. Y'all know I pay for shit. This goes into the taxes. Okay. Let's see what we got here. We're going to take off the Paco Rabanne cover and see. Oh, mira que está, mira. Que mira. They packaged it for me. Mira que está. Must be nice. Must be nice. Oh, I didn't want the tote bag because it's not my color. But let's look at the tote bag first, see what the tote bag is. Does this consider a designer tote bag? I guess. I don't give them to my wife. I let her look at them. I say, I'm going to save them. So when you want to use it, you can use it. But we don't need just to fucking throw it into the pile. I want you to keep it somewhere nice. See? Let me try it out. Yeah, it fit. Don't fit me so good. That's all right. But they gave me this. I didn't want it, but, you know, they threw it in. So the wife felt like that, you know. And what woman does not like more tote bags? And they gave me some samples of stuff I already smelled. And they gave me something else in here. Ooh, a sample. And they gave me my own travel decant of Paco Rabanne parfum. So I can travel with it. I got fame in here I've never smelled. I got 1 million I have smelled. And I got 1 million parfum, Invictus parfum. Huh? Okay, I got one of those. What the fuck is this? Is this 1 million? Yeah, so they sent me a little. So I got like 3 different 1 million decants here. So let me see. I got a small sample of it. I'll probably put in a drawing one day. And then I got some 1 million, which I've already smelled. And I want to smell mine out the bottle. I'm not going to smell this. But I'm going to smell this fame one. If it's any good, I might get it for my wife. Let's see. The notes are teeth, human. Oh, that's jasmine. I'm sorry. It looked like fucking teeth. Human teeth. I swear to God, it looks like human teeth. Okay. This is the. Let's spray it. See what it smells like. It smells like a flower. Just, you know, all women's designer fragrances smell the same to me. It smells nice. I don't know if my wife will like it, but yeah, it's nice. There we go. So I got those samples included in this thing. Then I got this one. I guess it's a 10 ml. Me like a tie. I got my own 10 ml. Must be nice. Let me see. What kind of 10 ml I got here? Everybody's just, that's beautiful. Look at that. That's what I'll take with me when I wear it. That's pretty cool. Man, yeah, that's cool. I like that. Okay, moment of truth. Here we go. Paco Rabanne Parfum. Invictus. Here we go. There's the box, classic Invictus box. Man, that one doesn't smell that bad, to tell you the truth, Phantom. I'm going to smell it, give my first reaction, then I'm going to let it sit on my skin, chat with you guys for a second, see what it kind of evolves into. I don't know. I'm not going to hate on any designer fragrance because they're all cool, in my opinion. As long as they smell good, I don't care if they smell like everything else. Ooh, beautiful bottle. Look at that bottle. Look at that gorgeous bottle, folks. I can't wait till they come out with the 200 ml, this badass. I'm on the wait list for the 200 ml. Got to have the 200 ml, this one. It's beautiful. It's gorgeous. Look at that thing. That is just beautiful. Don't even want to spray it. It's so pretty. I got to make samples, though. Because once you take this top off, man, it ain't never the same again. So here we go. On the skin. Good sprayer. All over that skin. Let's spray the whole arm. In fact, let's spray both arms. Hell, fuck it. Okay. Here's the thing with this one. It reminds me of everything else. I wish they just would have went for the DNA of the OG and just said, fuck it. Give me that. It just smells like Bad Boy, Paco Rabanne Phantom. YSLY. Polo Blue. It's all the same. Okay, there we go. Now it smells better. It took a second. I think it's got all that in it, but then it's got the original DNA in it, too. Are women going to love the way you smell? Hell yeah. This one's going to be a hit. Women going to love the way this smells on a man. Especially younger women. It's nice. It does have that DNA. It kind of reminds me of a little bit of Intense. A little bit. Maybe Intense and Aqua mixed together. I don't get all aqua on this. That's for damn sure. I'm happy with the purchase. You can always tell if it's a real Paco Rabanne or not. You know how? Flip it over, okay? You see that thing right there? All right? No liquid goes in the bottom, all right? The fake ones will always have liquid in that will fill up the bottom because it's too expensive to make two pieces. So they make one, and then the hole is left there, and it fills up. So you know it's a real deal. That's one of the signs you can always tell. No liquid in here. It's just glass. You open it up, see nothing empties out. Still the same, see? Nothing fills this up. It's just for looks. That's how you can tell. You can also tell by taking this top off and seeing how the sprayer is. But I like the top, too. It's got the R on top. That's never been on this before. This is definitely really nice. Super expensive. I am going to be ordering the new Prada Luna Ocean, if you're asking. That'll be in a couple days. Let's catch up on the comments real quick. We have 30 people watching. I'll make sure I say hi to everybody. Lawless, what's going on, baby? Okay, I have to check it out, LaShawn. I will. I haven't tried either one of those, but I've heard really a lot of things about Vengeance Radio, a lot, and it's on my list. What do you think about there, Lawless? You trying to, RXL loves it now. He's a shill for Curly Fragrance. What's up, Kushy K? How are you? You know, Kushy K, when you said the other night, somebody sent me a clip, and I think you were in the clip, not for the reason for you, but it was for me to see, because they were talking shit about me. And you said that somebody, the host of the show you were on, had a low body count, and I about fucking dropped what I was doing and laughed so hard. I thought that was hilarious. And just the way you said it, because you said it with such distaste for even wanting to be there. Maybe you were just high. I don't know. Okay, Orange is telling us World War III has officially started. Well, I'm going to go get in my bunker, but I'm going to take this with me. Duncan, you sent me a song. I have no idea what the fuck I'm supposed to do with it. It is, Fire God is a signature scent worthy. It is a year round, but it's a little too, for a lady, I could see that, or for somebody who could really, who's metrosexual, I could see that being a singer scent. But if you are more masculine, you can't make that really your signature scent. You can wear it, but I think for a man, it just needs to be a little bit more masculine. That's just me. That's why I want to make like Fire God my signature scent. It's worth it, every bit of it. But it's just too, I think a signature scent for a man should be something only a man can wear and not a woman. That's just me. Blue Chanel, that's a man. Hermana Coach from Tat Libre Orange. That was, it said unisex, but I didn't know a girl who wore it. Of course, Tiger's a men's fragrance. Blue Dog, they say it's unisex, but I still feel like it's a men's fragrance. Hmm. 12 turns in a row. That's right. Hey, did you see? I love these. You know what? She told me that she couldn't. You don't see the Spice Bomb comparison, but I do. Maybe it's just my nose. I haven't smelled it since I reviewed it. I haven't worn it since then, and I probably won't wear it. I'm debating on just selling the rest of it and moving on because people keep asking me for more. I'm still debating on buying another bottle. Maybe I should have bought a bottle of that instead of Zaharoff. What do you think? I love George Zara, but the demand for Curly is huge. Yeah, you sent me a song. On Instagram, or maybe it wasn't, it was recently. Then a day, Hawaii Volcano from Alexandria, a great fragrance. So I got this on my skin. It smells really nice. Is it really groundbreaking? No. Did I expect it? I was more enjoying the bottle, the everything they sent me, the bag, the fragrances. I get more enjoyment out of that, sharing the content. I'm gonna wear this twice in my life, probably in the next year. It's not something that's going to, I'll review it. I'll let you know after a full wear if it's something I'm going to wear more than three times this year. But that's me. I have too much to wear. I've been doing duas all week. You know, I haven't even worn the City Rhythm one yet, which I can't wait to wear. I haven't worn the Alexandra one yet. I've worn everything else over there. I just got to review it. I shot a bunch of videos, and I still have all this shit piled up over there. I've got to do reviews on the stand over there. I kind of keep it all there so I know where I need to go next. But this one will probably take priority and move up. Say, I'll probably shoot one this week and post it soon because it takes priority. But I still got two more days of duas, so I'm rocking this one tomorrow. I wore it tonight. I'm going to rock it tomorrow, too. Tigers going. I mean, Tigers, Madagascar, Vanilla Ground. What the fuck is that? A big-ass damn mosquito. Shit. Coco Loco, baby. It's not that warm, but it's warm. Almost getting warm enough. Yeah, you can probably do. It's hard. There's not one I don't like except for that chocolate one. I don't know. Irene Detour Noir. Do you guys know what that's a clone of? I have no idea. I thought he was saying it was a clone of me. I was like, damn, they made a clone of me? Shit. Must be nice. I got a clone. Hey, if you, yes, I haven't worn it lately, but if you want to pick up Perseus right now, you can get it at Vemba for $299, which is about $85 less than I paid for it. So that's about where you're going to get it right now for. So it's still $300 at Vemba if you want to get Perseus. It was available. I don't like Leighton. I sold my bottle of Leighton pretty quick. They're big. They're big down here. Oh, it's a Leighton clone. Yeah, I think that sounds about right. I'm gonna go back in on this one now. Yeah, it's a sweeter Invictus Aqua. That's what I can put it. I haven't tried that one. Only one I've tried from Genre is Puerto Rico. It's the only one I bought because it makes money. I don't like it. I don't like Genre from when I mean, I don't hate it, but it is nothing I reach for to wear. I'm hoping my two new bottles coming in. Maybe there's something different about them, because they released 64 bottles of them and I picked up two. Must be nice to pick up two bottles. That's right. They're huge. They're huge. I gotta give them credit though. They packed it up real nice. And I almost don't want to like mess with this box. I want to do something with it, you know, like give it as a gift to somebody, you know, not the stuff in it, but, you know, I'm probably just going to hand this over to my wife. I shouldn't have told about it. I should just gave it to her as a present. It's my dumb ass. Look, baby, I got you something from Paco Rabanne. That'd be nice. Oh, don't mess up the inside one. You're poking holes in it. Hold on. See, I can put this right back in there like that, right? Buy her a bottle of this, right? Of this one, right? Put it right back in there. Just give it to her as a gift. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. I'm just going to give it to her as a gift. Baby, they didn't send the bag. I'm sorry. It's no bag in there. It's a nice box, man. It really is. Look at that. It's a nice, dirty box. You could do something with it. You know, it's a, you know, I don't know, something with it. I have so many boxes. Like, I have so many Louis Vuitton boxes, and I've got a big box over here of Rocha. Two of those. You know, the Chanel boxes are really nice too. The Dior boxes, when you order one of the Dior, you know, selects, they come in a real nice box too. But I guess I'm gonna wear this very, very soon. I might wear it tomorrow. And since I wore the duo tonight and take a break from the duos, but I gotta keep the 7 days of duos going. There you go. You can get it right there. Just make sure it's real. I don't shop anywhere but Vemba and Fragrance by Canada. I learned my lesson. I'll pay a little bit more for it before I shop anywhere else anymore. No drama shop for me. No frag flex for me. No place where anybody's shilling to give me a code for me. I just don't trust. I don't trust them. And I sell decans, so I can't get fake shit. And as much as people want to tell me it's real, I know where I got my Perseus. It's 100% real, by God. real. And I trust Bemba. I don't trust anybody else. That's just me. Everybody else, you buy what you want to buy. But me, I learned my lesson. I don't know what the ruse is. I don't know. I don't know, Lawless. Bug Zapper in there. I don't know if they sell fake shit. I just hear stories. The watered down shit. I hear shit. I'm just telling you. My thing is, maybe one day I need to buy a bottle from Vemba and then buy a bottle from one of these other places like Max Roma and compare them. Because I don't trust a lot of people. I run a business, so I just, you know, I'd rather trust an individual on eBay than some of these fragrance companies. I just part. There's a reason why they cost more money than there's a reason why it's $299 on Vemba and $220 somewhere else. It's not because they bought it somewhere cheaper. They're all buying it from the same wholesalers. They're all buying it from the same people. So my thing is, why is it so much cheaper? That's my question. And sometimes you're getting a French edition of it, you know, overseas, things are different. I don't know. I feel like my 3.4-ounce bottle of Blue Electrique does not smell as good as my 2.0-ounce bottle of Blue Electrique that I got when it came out and the one I bought afterwards. They're identical, but this one smells different. And that's just me. So I maybe it's me. I'm wrong. I don't know. The batch codes were good. Everything matched up. And they did produce 3.4-ounce Blue Electriques, not here in the States to sell, but overseas. Like, if you went into a duty-free place overseas, you could find them in airports, you know, in places like that. And some people, you know, that's, you know, I have warehouses overseas. I don't know. I'm the old school, and I'm a firm believer in this. If it looks too good to be true, then most of the fucking time it is. I've sold enough product in my life of all different sorts, from cars, electronics, lumber, insurance. And every deal I ever saw or made that was too good to be true, most time was not true. I'm just telling you. I would be careful. I like Bemba. I'll pay Bemba a little extra just to know I know what I'm getting. Except when they jip me and they say they ran out of one. Just because they priced it wrong at $160. They my fault. Send me that shit. They had a Virgin on Water 3.4-ounce with a cap for $160. I was like, bet, I'll take it. And then when they told me, I got the email saying, we're out of stock. I was like, okay, whatever. Send me my damn shit. I don't know if they're selling fakes. Like I said, I really don't know. And there are, what I've learned, there is two, but I don't know, Lawless. That's what I hear. I don't know. The buzz, I didn't even know there was a Zaharoff coming out. Now, I don't pay attention to shit. I am not on other people's channels looking. I mind my own business. I support my friends in different ways, but I don't really watch their videos or streams or join in. So if somebody's telling me that there is a new Zaharoff coming out, it was my wife. She told me, because I had no idea. I don't even get in the Zaharoff chat. I mean, if I can't advertise my decants in the Zaharoff chat, I'm not gonna get in there so much. I mean, you know, it's about the time. It wasn't made for me. It was made for people who want to talk about the fragrances all day. I talk about them already all day. I get no joy. No joy at all having to get in the fragrance discussion on Facebook. I don't. So I try to avoid it. It's not because I'm a stuck-up bastard. Because I do it already so many times. And I answer so many messages, which I don't mind. I answer everybody's message, whoever messages me, who can't get a hold of me, and they have a question about a fragrance, I answer it. Hell yeah. But I'm not going to interject myself into a lot of conversations. I'm like, nah, I'm good. Unless I'm picking on the milk patrol, then, you know, then it's fair game. Hit the like, nerds. That's right. You tell them. What's up, Mike? Mike had a stream earlier, but I couldn't get on. Mike, you had a great guest. I was in the background listening. I was at work. Great stream. It's good to see Mike here. You know, Mike is a good guy. Stands his ground. I think, you know, I think he lets people Mike, do what you got to do, baby, and hold your ground. Don't let nobody tell you difference. RXL is now not only shilling for Curly Fragrance, he's shilling for Jumma Shop too now. Be careful with RXL. He's changing on us. He is not shilling for neither one of them. I refuse to shop on Jumma Shop. There's just too much damn simping going on with Jumma Shop. Like I said before, I'll pay a little extra. I'm good. Must be nice to pay a little extra. Must be nice. I know it's nice. What is up, Mr. Gumbo, a.k.a. Hot Grease? I don't think so. Everything I ever bought from them was 100% real. I can prove that. I think they just been in business a little bit longer and they have a little bit more room. They probably are a better negotiator when it comes to their wholesaling prices because they get shit way ahead of some people. And Venba is, Jumma Shop is overpriced to begin with. Can we say that already? It's overpriced. I would never shop on Jumma Shop for about maybe one thing out of 20 you find on there is fucking overpriced. The one thing that people find is cheaper is the one they tell you about and everybody tells you about. They don't tell you about the 10 other things they found there that were nowhere near as cheap as Fragrance by Canada or Venba. I've never had a person, a customer tell me that this was fake. So I feel pretty good about this too. Hell no, I ain't going nowhere near Triple Traders anymore. I don't trust them either. They sold me a fake. Fragrance Net's okay. Fragrance X is okay. They've been around a while, but they're not cheap either. They're all overpriced. I just pay the retail price when it comes out. Then I gotta worry about it. Must be nice. I know you can't stand Jumma Shop. Yeah, I'm not gonna watch it, but you watch it for me. I can't sit through one UFC fight. There's no way I can sit through five of them. Oh God. I tried UFC. I was like, no, this is not for me. I miss boxing. It was just more scientific. I don't know. I have a low attention span. I can't really watch anything anymore that's not interesting. That's maybe it's what it's Rainy Men with the Milk Patrol. That's right, baby. That's right. It is. And you know they ain't gonna ride stuff. What's up, Stan? Great to see you, Stan. I think I missed you last time, Stan. What's up, Stan? Triple Fragrances. I don't even know who Triple Traders is, to tell you the truth. I know don't buy from Bill's Outlet, I'll tell you that much. That I'm still fighting them over that 150. They still ain't sent me a return label. Looks like I'm going to lose out on that 150. I'm going to call it a loss. I'll write it off. I don't want to talk about it right now. It's none of my business. None of my business. Keep doing what you're doing. If you can't figure it out on your own, then it's really not a big deal. Damn, it's fucking flies in here. What the fuck are these gnats coming from? Ain't no food back here. It's the damn fragrances. I'm gonna have to damn do something about that. Fucking gnat. Too many lights on back here. They're attracted to all of them. Oh, man. Anyways, let's go back to this fragrance now. I'm gonna go back in. It's been sitting on my skin for a little while. It smells like an Invictus fragrance now. That's probably closer to what I was saying right there. I think you should stand your ground a little bit more. You ain't got to be everybody's friend. One is good. I don't even know who Triple Traders is, to tell you the truth. I bought something from Beale's Outlet, and they sent me a fake, and they're giving me the hardest time to return it. And they won't send me a return label. Now they stop responding to my messages. This is a big company. So I'm going to be calling PayPal and filing a claim against them. Then we'll get them to get my money back to me. Anyways. Cracked threes. I just don't like MMA. It's just a young man's thing. It's not my thing. I just, when somebody says, oh, you watched the fight last night with Roberto Ortiz and Victor Salva, my own fucker. I don't even know who they are. I know who Joe Rogan is. That's about it. Is he still fighting? That's all I know. I know about the old school ones, like that dude who, not the Gracies before them, the Terminator. I know about the Terminator and whatever his name his was. That son of a bitch was a badass. I used to watch it when it was real, when you kill somebody in the ring, because that's why you watched it. I'm just saying, that's why I watched it. I remember when there was no weight divisions and you would see like this big ass sumo wrestler fighting this little dude who knew kung fu and shit. It was real life kumite shit, man. I liked it then. Now it's just weight classes and fucking shit and damn referees. Back in those days, it was just straight up kumite shit. So I just don't like it now. I always thought MMA should have been more aggressive and more violent. I get it. I get why it isn't. But I can see the appeal of it. I just don't get into it. What is the name of that guy? We talked about this guy before. His name is Dan the Terminator or something. He was like unbeatable. He fought that 7-foot Chinese guy or that Japanese guy. And that was like the best fight I ever saw in my life. I think I showed it to you guys one day. I'll try to find it. What was his name? Somebody tell me his name. You guys know who I'm talking about. The guy with the mustache. The old dude. Back in the day. Dan something, the Terminator. That's it. Maybe that's it. I think that's it right there. It's boring now, I smell, because you ain't got nobody to look up to, but you got to understand when I grew up. Okay, I'm going to show you I smell what's not boring, okay? I'm about to show you I smell. Okay, I'm about to show I smell what real fight looks like, okay? I'm just going to show you the first round of Hagler-Hearns, okay? This is real boxing, and this is real fighting all at once. These dudes, but they were great boxers. They were feared. They were the best. Watch the way they go at it. You would never get a boxer today to box like this. This is why I fell in love with boxing. I saw some of his kids. I watched it with my dad, and I was very, very young, barely old enough to remember. And I think this was it. It was one of the Hagler-Hearns fights. Either my dad showed me a video of it, or we talked about it. I don't remember which one it was. But this is the best I've ever seen a fight. These two dudes go fucking at it from the word go.
Both fighters, they instructions in the dress room. I'm just cautioning you now. Obey my command.
He'll probably get blocked now, by the way. Just letting you know.
As Ray said, Tommy Hearns usually likes to establish dominance for himself up.
These motherfuckers right here. This is real fighting. Fuck MMA. Watch this shit.
The first one's a key round.
No fucking around either. No fucking around.
This is up tempo right at the opening bell. Hagler being the aggressor. Hearns working this right at it. A very quick jab. There's no denying it. And he caught Hagler with two good jabs and a right hand that might have hurt Hagler.
You do not get fight like that anymore. Look at this shit. They're going at it, son. And they're hitting too. Technical. No damn wild pros either. All that technical. Look at these two dudes. Look at them go.
And a left hand by Hagler.
They're fucking fighting. The whole fight is like this. That's way better than MMA. Sorry.
You know, both the guys just winging shots. So whoever gets caught in the chin.
Golly, look at the fucking connection every time.
Both men have felt the wrath of the other.
Tommy is hurt. Fuck around, man.
Shaking, unsteady. And a left hand by
that's
Hearns.
Why I fell in love with boxing. It's just beautiful to watch. That's just me. I'm a little weird.
Hagler now just uses defense. He's walking towards
I'm going to that fight. What was his name? Right Dan, what?
Harris is on his bicycle. Hadley now approaches his bike.
Dan.
Remember, rolled in. What's his name?
Dan.
Early on also.
Seven. I think that was his name.
Another good straight right hand.
Versus right Japanese hand. Tall guy. I think it was Japanese tall guy. I can't remember the guy's name.
Headlock balance.
Tall guy.
Good guy. For the right hand lead that time.
Here we go. This motherfucker's going at it too. It's ridiculous. This is unbelievable right here. This is like I'd be scared to fight either one of these
dudes.
MMA, if you give me shit like this, I'll come back. Give me fights like this, I watch it every fight, every time it comes on. Give me grown men fighting, and I'll come back. This is the shit.
Let's see if we can do it again. That guy right there, Yoshihiro Takayama.
Look at this dude. You gonna fuck him? Hell no, I'm gonna run free. I'm gonna run away. Even me, I'm gonna run away. They get the fighting. I tell you, that's the best scared, by the way. Neither one of them are scared. Neither one of them are fucking scared at all. Fucking shit. Look at that stick.
Hey,
stand the corner. Yeah, I'm like, what's up, Pat White? Well, watch this shit right here. Look at this motherfucker. He's a killer. He would beat the shit out of any damn MMA guy now.
Go!
Watch it. From the get.
Look at
this.
There's that right hand. They're cooking it up. That's right with the right hand. Takayama.
Boom. You tell me. MMA, you give me that, I'm in. Give me that right there, and I'll watch again. Give me that shit. They don't. But boring.
And
MMA will never give me that. That's why I don't watch. This is a big joke.
Wow.
I've never.
That's what I want to see. That. I don't want to see these guys grapple on the ground trying to break somebody's arm. That's boring to me. This is amazing.
Unbelievable. Everything that we was boring tonight.
Anywho, I've played this before.
Unbelievable.
I'm just saying, if they would go back to this,
you're holding and hitting, you
can't force the body. I always thought MMA was more about street fighting, more about man versus man. Boxing was more about artistry and style.
Just under the left eye, Yoshihiro.
Here he fucked him up. They're done.
Panty took down shot. But it
all right, that's about it. I mean, they end up going at it again. But I've watched this full match. It's a great match.
Like I said.
And they fought more than once. They have fought several times. So, yeah, he fucked his nose up right away, didn't he? MMA has evolved, found the ground game. Yeah, it's the horse, all the damn jujitsu shit that the horse Gracie, the Gracies ruined MMA. Ruined it. Dan should have been the face of MMA. And Horace Gracie became the face of MMA because he could damn grapple Dan down. What's that? With a technical thing that nobody really knew how to defend yet. They figured it out after a while, but it was too late. Never impressed with the Gracies. Never impressed with none of that. They ruined MMA for me. I was done after that. Just me. But I'm glad everybody likes it. It's very, very popular. And I just don't know much about it. I'm going to do it tonight, guys. When I get off here, I'm going to pack your orders. I'm going to finish Fallout, which I got one episode left. Fantastic series. If you love the game, you're going to be very, very happy. And I'm going to watch the Alabama A-Day game. I'm going to watch Alabama play against each other because I'm football nuts. That's just me. But this fragrance, though, it's growing on me. I like it. It smells like an Invictus fragrance now. You're going to get compliments. People are going to love the way you smell. I'll wear it soon. I'll give you a full review on it. I think it's beautiful. I really, really like it as far as, you know, a standard Invictus fragrance. It's not bad. What is that? You did. That's awesome, dude. I think he's still alive. Did he die finally? What's up, Terry? Smiles. Great to see you, Terry. Dan Fry is his name. It's Dan Fry. It's not Dan Severn. It's Dan Fry. I thought it was Dan Fry. Yeah, that's a great fight, man. Listen. Tank Abbott, too. Tank Abbott, yeah. Tank Abbott. What's up, he delivered. Tank Abbott was another one. Damn, he was scary. just don't get scared. You know, the new MMA don't scare me. Ronda Rousey doesn't scare me. Ronda Rousey makes me want to, you know, another thing. I like him. I like him a little bigger. You know what I'm saying? I like him a little voluptuous. So, you know. I liked her in the movie, in the Entourage series. Great to see Terry here. Can't see, okay. I tell you what, he don't need a weapon. His hands are lethal weapons. God almighty. If there was a such thing as a kumite, they would have sent his ass to it, and he would have won the motherfucker. He wasn't losing to nobody. Have you ever seen the clips of the guys who say they go to the kumite? If you don't know what the kumite is, it's the fake or some shit that Frank Dukes said he went to, which a lot of Frank Dukes' stuff is based off the movie Kickboxer or Bloodsport, excuse me. And Bloodsport was the movie that really projected, you know, shot Van Damme's career up. Now, Van Damme did know martial arts, okay? It's no joke. He didn't know martial arts. He could have kicked your ass if he wanted to. He really could. But the kumite, I still don't know if it's a real thing or not. Now, what I would say, if it did exist, who would you send today to the kumite is what I want to know. Or even better, if there was a fragrance reviewer kumite, who would you send? Oh my God, that should be a whole fucking stream. That would be great. The fragrance kumite. Who do we send? Well, we can't send me. I'm too old. We got to send somebody young. No, it's not like Fight Club. Kumite, you know, they had the bent in, ring. You send RXL. He's too old, too. He won't last but 2 days. RXL would be like me and RXL would be like Van Damme's best friend. We'd fucking end up in the hospital. We don't need to go. We're too old. We just send our young people. Unless all we're going to send is young people, old people. Then if we're going to send the old people, then me and RXL can both go. You know, RXL does know judo. We don't need to go. We won't last 2 minutes. I don't care what kind of shape RXL's in. Or a bad shape I'm in. What's up, Spence? Gracie Spence here. We're not going to make it. So who do we send? I guess we would send Cuba, maybe. No, he's too old, too. We can't send Cuba. He's too small, way too short. Who can we send? Do we send Jeremy? I think we could send. And I know Jeremy's about my age or close to, a little bit younger than me, not much younger than me. He's probably like in his 40s now. We could still send Jeremy. So we would send Jeremy. He's more physically fit, right? Who else can we send? If we were having a kumite for kids, then we could send some other people too. I'm just saying, that was too soon. Damn. CM Punk. Yeah, we could send Ross. He's big enough, but he's not. He just makes sure that he can't get any fight with anybody with any reach. If they got the reach, it's fucking over. Okay, you gotta watch the reach. So we gotta make sure we don't put him up against somebody like, say, that's about as tall as George, then it's over. Yeah, post-Cologne be a good one. Yeah, young folks. You know, we could send Pop Sins. Pop Sins pretty young. He got a little weight. He got a little punch to him. We could send doesn't that guy know karate? The one that, what's his name, RXL? The one that tried doing a dating app site too. And Dogman fucking called him out. What was his name? Doesn't he know karate? Or is that just because he's Asian? I think he knows karate. And I'm being racist. Probably being racist. Big D would work, yeah. Like that, you know. That's right. I hate cardio. Like, I do 20. This has been the best week for me gym wise. I have been 4 days. I didn't go today because I was tired, but I'm going to go tomorrow. Yeah, I've had a great week. I did cardio 2 days a week. I did 15 minutes on the damn elliptical and 15 minutes on the treadmill. I got my heart rate up to about 140. I'm fucking dying. And then during the upper body days, two of those, I just did 20 minutes on the just walking. I'm not trying. I hate cardio. I got to work myself back into it. I used to be able to do the elliptical for 20 minutes at a decent speed and be fine. I was like, damn, what happened to that one? And that wasn't that long ago. That was like a year and a half ago. So I have been going solid this week. So I have been a total of 8 days out of the 15 so far. My goal is to go at least 3 to 4 times a week and work my little workout. It's like 35 minutes long. It's just, I can feel the difference in my arms already a little bit, trying to get that back in. That's right. Judo. You don't know if I got a knife. You don't know if I got a gun. You don't know what I got. Conor McGregor is more of a cartoon character, right? Right? He was horrible in that Roadhouse movie, by the way. I fucking couldn't even finish it. I was like, this is horrible. Bring me back. I miss Patrick Swayze. As long as I can do the throat thing and take out their fucking throat, it'd be fine. I guess we could send Bowtie Fragrance Guy, right? We got to make sure we have diversity. We could send... we got to send a woman. Who can we send that can fight? Shit. Like, I don't know. Okay. We don't have to send women, but we can send them as the valets. They can be the valets to the fighters. What do you think? There we go. We can have RXL walk down with Curly Sense as your valet and her your choice of what you want her to wear, RXL. No, I ain't gonna say it because I'll get in trouble. I'll be quiet. I'm on the what? I'm on the freeway. I've been live for about an hour and I'm about to stop, Spence. We just finished talking about this bad boy. Did you order it? I don't know if you did or not. But it starts off like a typical sweet designer, but by the end of it, it smells like Invictus. So that's all I can really say about it. They send it in a really nice box with a tote bag and some samples. And I got my own 10 ml carrying thing, which I'm grateful for because I've already sold 3 10 ml's of this thing. So I didn't want to. They sent me my own personal 10 ml too. All in all, I think I spent $140 with shipping and everything. To me, I've already sold 5 samples of this. I'm at $100 so far. So I'm almost there making my money back, and I get to enjoy the fragrance. So it's not a bad deal. I did order a fragrance. I sent you to Spence. What do you think about that picture of that fragrance I sent you? I want to ask you guys your opinion on it. I just picked it up. Let me know if you guys have tried this fragrance because I'm very curious. It's from the same house where I got that Desiree Toxic. And I don't see it. Did I not buy it? I think I sent it to him. No, that's not it. Here it is. Hold on, Spence. I sent it to you. I think I sent it to you. I think I did send it. I think I sent it to the wrong person. All right, damn. I sent it to the wrong person, Spence. But here it is right here. This fragrance is called Osatio. Can y'all see that? Can't fucking tell if y'all can see that or not. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. So it says, there you go. M. Khalif Osatio. Now I have Desiree Toxique. I love the notes on this thing, man. This thing has got amazing notes. Let me pull them back up so I can show them to you. Copy. I'm gonna go back into the right Nanica and show you the notes on this. Have y'all tried this one? It does smell like it. And did I say that in my review, RXL? I can't remember. Did I say that? Do you like it, RXL? Yeah, M. Khalif, that's it. Oliveria is about to lose, RXL. Thank you for keeping us up on that. I appreciate it. So this one has got some great notes in it. Now, they also make a gin and tonic one I want to try, okay? But this one is called Osatio. I guess I'm saying it right. It came out in 2016. It's got C notes, citrus, grapefruit, mirth in the middle, marigold, musk, exotic wood, sandalwood, and amber. I love the notes on everything. And it's comparable to Millesime Imperial. I can't tell what that is. Some kind of Acqua di Palma, Nishane Egi, Silver Mountain Water. So it's all in that kind of vein. But then they also make this one that sold out before I can get to it. They're gin and tonic. I really want to try that one. This one has the notes of, listen to this, tonic water, lime, ginger, gin, peppermint, pink pepper. Then some floral notes in the middle, nutmeg. I mean, this thing looks amazing. It's called Gin and Tonic from M. McAleef. I want to get this one. It's next on my list. Yeah, I want Gin and Tonic so bad. I think Dua has a clone of it, and I love that. I did a video on it. So I can't wait to try it. But that one, I have... Yeah, it's you can get it right now for $100 on Venmo, which is about the cheapest you're going to see it, and that's where I got mine at. And it's a, I love Desert Toxic. It has a musky aquatic vibe. It smells a little bit like, it's in the same kind of vein that say is Ortiza Porossi's Mega Mare. It's in that vein. I love Perseus. It's the best release of the year, in my opinion. It has the vibe of Tia de Jiménez. I never, it does have the vibe, but it's its own thing. I love it. It's one of the best. And how is the performance for you, RXL? I got an amazing performance out of that damn thing. It's easily going to be nominated for fragrance, niche fragrance release of the year, without a doubt. Now, you know me, I don't get every single niche release, but the two that I have gotten, the most high profile being Isola Sol and Perseus, which were both trying to cater to the same market, Isola Sol failed miserably. Like, I will never wear that fragrance again. Not even if somebody pays me to. Well, who knows? Pay me a lot of money. Now, Perseus is longer lasting than any Tierra de Jiménez. Tierra de Jiménez still smells synthetic, even though it's a little synthetic, not a lot. Perseus is the perfect summer fragrance to come out this year. Easy for me. That's just for me. You know what? It would almost replace Tiger if it was a year-round fragrance. Or it would become a great one. It's no big deal, brother. You've been driving and working. Yeah, it's not bad for $100. I thought I sent you the picture. I might send it to somebody else, Spence. I apologize. I don't think so. I think they're different, man. And if you are Excelsior, you can get a fake one for $220. I always feel bad when I have to charge so much for my bottles. You know, it's like when I get my stuff in, it's like, hell, it's $385, which I've already sold out the bigger sizes of the Perseus anyways. All I really have left is like 3 mls. It is so, I'm so picky with Perseus. Like, I don't want to buy another bottle. I'm going to sell it, and I might have to because of the fact that it sells so well in my store. There's about that much left in there, and I still want to wear that. Like, I want to wear it again. I don't like a Guibre. I still prefer, I can't even pronounce it. I'm fucking it up. I still like better Tierra de Jiménez Trey Fresh. Never bought Frag Flex, not once. Like I said, I'm old school, man. I stick to my tried and trues. I've never been disappointed with fragrance by Canada with shipping. Venba's unbelievably shipping. And I usually buy, you know me, RXL, I buy before they fucking... I don't have a choice on most things. If I can get it when it releases, that's when I want to get it. Because A, I'll either wear it and enjoy it and make content out of it and sell, and B, I'll sell enough to recoup some of my money, not all of it, all the time. Most of my profits come from Dua, I ain't gonna lie. Today we had done $785 in sales. Okay, one day yesterday we did $900 in sales. So, and the majority of it is Dua. Excuse me, I got a little burping problem going on here. Yeah, do it. So I'm sorry, we're at $488 today, and yesterday we did $588. I was off. Today. I'm in the wrong day. Okay, yeah. So $488 yesterday and $619 today. So $1,000 in 2 days. And I would say 80%, I say 60% of it is due. So I make my money back on that. So the fact that I don't mind paying retail for it. I know you guys don't, but I don't mind. I feel like I can give you guys a fair assessment of a fragrance. In the chat, before I even brought up Isola Soar and you saw it, before I even bought it or thought about buying it and you had saw it, were you thinking about getting it? And after you read my review, are you still going to get it? After you watch my review? No, probably not, because I say I took the hit for you, and I'm saying I might make my money back. I might lose money on that one. Just saying. Yeah, yeah. Well, if you had some insurance on it. No, it's a unisex fragrance. I thought so too. Me too. I thought so too, but it says unisex. And when I went to the website, it was unisex. But it is definitely a chick fragrance, man. It is. It's not even a chick fragrance. It's an old lady's fragrance. Now, I don't mean like my old lady. I mean like aged fine wine old lady. You need to get you some insurance, man. Listen, I don't even care. Charge me $17-$20 a month, whatever you want for the insurance. You know why? Because I damn sure hate buying new phones. Just replace it. That's just me. I've been doing this too many times with kids. If a controller goes out, I just call the insurance and they replace my controllers. If my computer goes out, God willing it doesn't, or this $1,000 mixing board goes out, it's covered. For how many years I have it, it's covered. So I always do not mind paying for insurance on electronics because they tend to go out, you tend to break them, and it's always cheaper to pay a deductible than it is to pay for a new phone. Ah, but you got to pay that. Yeah, but guess what? You know how many damn much money I waste a month that I can... if you waste more than $20 a month on frivolous stuff, you should never be complaining about a bill you got to pay every month. Golden Girls vibe. That's it. It's time for a new iPhone. Anyways, I didn't crack my flip, my Android phone. Yeah. Well, me and you got the same kind of phones. I have an iPhone 15 Pro and then a Flip 5 and a Flip 3 and a Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus tablet, the nicest one they make. That thing, it looks great when you watch sports on there. It's 4K. I think the thing will even shoot in 8K. If there was 8K available, the thing would put it out. Love that tablet. No lag, no nothing. It's a 512 memory on my phone and then 1 terabyte on my tablet. So I got plenty of memory. I don't know why I have a terabyte on my tablet. That's kind of pointless because I don't put nothing on there. All right. Let's wrap this up. I like it. I'll do a review on it. The bottle's cool looking, right? Looks really cool. It's a fingerprint magnet like the rest of them. We will not have a stream Sunday. We will get back to the Lord tomorrow, and I will get back to myself for packing orders. I have to work. I am not off again until Friday, so... Probably we're going to have a duo stream for the haul video. It's going to be super fast because only like 6 fragrances that came out that I will get on Monday. So if you pre-ordered those, I'm going to be working on the pre-orders Monday during the day and then shipping them out Tuesday morning. Duo's supposed to deliver my stuff on on Monday. It's overnighted, and I already signed for it, so it should be just dropped off at my house. Not that many. It's like six of them in there. They finally started doing my overnight shipping without me asking. Thank you, Dua. Must be nice. I know. I know. I think what they're doing now is just taking longer to ship it than give me overnight, so it ends up being the same damn time. I don't think they're doing that, but if they would have shipped that out FedEx, like it shipped out on Friday, that would never got to me to like Wednesday. So at least I'm getting it on Monday. If they could just ship it one day earlier, I could have got that on Saturday, and that would have been great. I just said I love that fragrance, Mike. I know I'm debating on pulling it from the shelf or buying another bottle. I love that fragrance. I'll sell it to you for $3 million. I'll even sign it. What's up, Mike? Great to see you. So we had about 35 people watching. And I want to say thank you for this impromptu stream. You guys, I want you guys to understand something. Thank you. I want to say thank you to the way you helped this channel grow. You let these streams allow me to let my hair down and be me. And just like in my videos, but I get to tell you a little bit about myself and enjoy life. There you go. But here's the problem with Harrods, okay? When you put it in your cart, you got to add the shipping. Add the shipping back in. I like buying from Harrods, but I know once I get it in my cart and you add that shipping back, it's like $60 because they're shipping it DHL from England. Wow, right back up. Hey, I know I saved it all up, right? There ain't no hair up there. It's gone, see? There's no hair up there. Sometimes I have to shave it to avoid the dog with the mange look, you know what I'm saying? So there's no more hair up there. It's gone. My butt hair. Yeah, you don't want to buy just one bottle because they're going to hit you for shipping for one bottle is like $60. Mike, you get that in your cart and you get to the end, it's going to, and I fell victim to this too. I was like, oh, they got Tiger for like $300. And then when I got to the end, it said $385. I'm like, what the hell? I ain't got that much taxes. It's where they get you in the shipping because they do ship it overseas. And you better be there to sign for it, too. If you ain't there to sign for it, forget about it. Thank you, brother. I appreciate it. I love all you guys. I want you guys to have a great week. Like I said, one more live stream. Plenty of content. And if you have made orders, I'm going to start working on tonight. And see what I can get out before I go to bed. I've got about 4 hours before I go to bed, so I'm going to work really hard at packing up as many as I can. I'm excited. I might even go to Home Depot. I am excited about my damn vacation. I will tell you that much. Because this vacation, I am going to be prepping to send you reviewers like Mike, Spence, RXL, PopSense, and some other folks that are in this chat, and anybody who makes a small request, I will pick 10 people, and I'm going to send you guys a Fatboy gift pack with a promo code that's specifically designed for your viewers only. So you'll be able to pump up the promo code and try a bunch of new releases. And then, you know, then I'll send you out. So I'll have a choice of what I have. You're going to get like 5 new releases. They're going to be in a 3ml decant. So you pick from those 5. If you can either get, it's probably going to be 3 to 5. You pick 3 if you want 3 of the more expensive ones, or you pick 5 if you want more cheaper ones. So that's how it's going to work. I'll send you a list of what you can pick. You can pick 3 from here and 2 from here. So, and then I'll send them to you. Free of charge. Is that you, buddy? Come in here and say hi. How you feeling? My boy's feeling better. Come here, baby. Come here and give me huggies. Oh, look at this hair, baby. I'm going to love you. I'm about to say goodbye. I'm about to get off here, too, and come take you in. You ain't that bad. Hey, can I play the guitar for everybody? Come on, let me play the guitar one time. All right, here's my guitar. Ready? Ding 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 ding. I love you. I'm coming up there. Put up your pants, son. Oh. Good night. I love you. I'm about to cut this off here and come tuck you in. He ain't been feeling too good, so he's feeling better. Anyways, the hair, right? That's how my hair used to look. Anyways, have a good night. Road Tide. I don't even think, what song I got playing, huh?
Bleeding your
sounds good to me.
Love it, baby. Hit the like button. Show the love. Join this channel. Join the revolution, baby. Share free revolution. The lone wolf of Fragcom. The most talented man in Fragcom. Have a great night.
Ready to attack now. Pulling the parking lot slow with the lockdown. Convicts got the whole thing packed up.
I mean, I wake up before I get back.
It's all at back now. I'm a father. Then I put the mic down. Money, no problem. Pocket full of hat now.
I feel you creeping. I can see my shadow. Shadow. I jump up in my Lamborghini Gallardo. Go to my place and just kick it like Tybo. I'm bleeding your hole. Look back and watch me smack that all on the floor. Smack that, give me some more. Smack that till you get sore. Smack that, oh, smack that all on the floor. Smack that, give me some more. Smack that till you get sore. Smack that, oh.
Oh, looks like another club banger. Better hang on, throw this thing on. Get a little drink on, egg on, flip, put a sack on, shit, you can bank on it. Pedicure, manicure, kitty cat claws, the way she climbs up and down them poles. Looking like one of them pretty cat dolls, trying to hold my booty back through my drawers. Steps up, days, didn't think I saw. Greets up behind me and she's like, yeah. I'm like, I know, let's cut to the chase. No time to wait, back to my place. Plus from the club to the crypts like a mile away. I'm more like a paddler, shall I say. And plus I got a pal at the gala's game. In fact, he's the one singing the song.
Hey girl, you creeping, I can see from my shadow. My shadow, I don't jump up in my Lamborghini Gallardo.
It's raining there.